All right, hour number two of our Sports Central extravaganza here at the Hilton Towers, and let's get right to our next group of guests. He had an outstanding year, his first year with the Cubs. Welcome, Ted Lilly. Starting shortstop for the Chicago Cubs, Ryan Thirio. And pitcher for the Chicago Cubs and one of the funniest human beings out there, Ryan Dempster, who, look how skinny he got. First of all, Ryan Dempster looks like he lost about, boy, you lost a lot of weight, dude. You're telling me no, you're looking good.
Oh, thanks.
And no, I'm not hitting on you.
They're testing now.
Guys, all ready for the season? It's not hard to believe, but spring training's right around the corner.
Seems like yesterday we were playing. I mean, it really does. Time flies, man. This is it's exciting. It's always exciting coming here and seeing all this. And one more, what is it, two more weeks? We'll be ready.
We had DeRosa and Dealey here earlier, and DeRosa said, got a bad taste in our mouths. Getting swept in Arizona or by Arizona was not a good thing. Ted, give us your thoughts. Wasn't a great series for anybody, for the Cubs.
No, none of us, you know, none of us really played well. We didn't really pitch well. Zambrano opened up game one and pitched well for us. But other than that, it wasn't very good. So I think that, you know, we can kind of use that in our favor and not really let it bother us, but use it as motivation for heading into this season.
You know, it's this is a game of inches. I think everybody knows that, especially the passionate fans here in Chicago who are students of the game. But you know...
What a politician.
That's right. You guys like that? No, you know, for me there at the end of the year, I think that we could taste it. I mean, I saw the playoffs. It was right around the corner. I think everybody was so excited to do something great. And we exerted so much energy in August and then through early September. I think we just kind of ran out of gas there at the end.
Like I said, I hope I never play anywhere else, because playing in front of 40,000 screaming fans and the rooftops and around Wrigley, it's awesome. You guys have no idea. Like, I know for you guys how exciting it is out there in the stands, but being a player, you guys really, I don't think you'll ever really understand how much we appreciate that as players, and I really mean. And so you do feed off it, that energy in the ninth inning. I said, you know, it was actually funny. I had some friends who went on a road trip this year, and they went to New York and watched the game at Yankee Stadium. They watched the Red Sox play the Yankees. Then they went to Fenway and saw Clay Buchholz throw the no-hitter against the Orioles. And then they came to Wrigley, and I came in. Dealey hit a home run against the Astros to go up by one, and I came in. And there was 10 of them. And you want to talk about pressure? If I blew, like... Their whole night was riding on me getting that save. Like, they saw a no-hitter at Fenway, went to Yankee Stadium, I had to get, and it was so loud in there, and I just fed off it, and it was, you know, got a couple of strikeouts and got out of there without blowing the save and got the win, and it was a lot of fun. It's intense. It's great.
Demp, is Lou kind of like the absent-minded grandfather that kind of wanders around and slaps? True story, you can confirm for us. I've heard that, number one, he calls him Stevie Iyer instead of Scott Ayer. And the other one is that one of your guys' equipment guys, he thought was Fontenot. And after Fontenot had five hits, he went up to the equipment guy and goes, heck of a game today, kid. Is that true?
That was actually our bullpen catcher, Corey Miller.
Your bullpen catcher. Lou thought he had five hits.
The funny part was Corey said thanks. Yeah, Lou's great, man. He's, you know, he's been around for a long time. He's probably seen it all. And, I think sometimes he does half the stuff just to kind of keep us guessing. So he's got quite the sense of humor. And, as we've seen, you know, quite the, he can let loose sometimes on the field.
Kind
Unfortunately,
of.
We only saw it once. I was hoping for, I had over-unders on how far the bases would get thrown and all kinds of stuff, but.
Yeah, D. Lee said that it was one of the funniest things he's ever seen, was June 2nd when Lou just went off on Mark Wegner. Did you guys, Ryan Thiriault, have a good time with that on the bench?
Oh, that was awesome. And everybody rushes back to that corner where he was yelling and screaming so we could get a little piece of the action and see what he was saying. Man, that was great. You come to the ballpark, Lou Piniella's your manager. Everybody's expecting to see something like that. I was hoping there toward the end of the season that he'd do it again, man, because we started really playing well after he started throwing bases.
Do you think, was there any correlation that Lou goes off, and he was wrong, by the way, the guy was out.
Yeah.
But is there any correlation? Because all of a sudden everything turns around.
I personally think yes. Because I don't know if people remember, but in the dugout a couple games before, the day before, we had a little scuffle, a couple guys.
Really? We hadn't heard about
that.
They
were arguing over, I guess, whose mom's spaghetti sauce was better. And so all of a sudden, Lou then goes out and has this rant with the umpire and right or wrong, and we didn't get asked another question about that fight the rest of the year. It was like that didn't even happen. All they want to know about was Lou.